Hello everybody, this is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome back to the Donkey Kong Country Returns playthrough. In our last episode, we continued our journey through the cliff with 6-6 and 6-7, and now we have only one level left to go, and then the boss, and we'll actually be done with this world so we can move on to World 7. And we are going to get this episode underway with 6-8, Clifftop Climb. I'll tell you, this level has made me want to jump off a clifftop, but hopefully we can get things done in this episode and finish the cliff for good. Anyway, at the very start of this level, pound this gong 3 times. And you will reveal your first puzzle piece, so there's 1 out of 5. And this level isn't really all that bad if you put in some good practice, like I did before this recording. Also, drop down into this barrel, and you'll be taken to the first of 2 bonus areas for this stage, and yes, it is the dreaded, horrible, painful death barrel. So let's go ahead and knock this out if we can, or we might get knocked out, you never know. And we're gonna do it! Thank goodness, we don't have to redo that one. But here's the main gimmick of Clifftop Climb. If you enjoy vertical platforming, then my friend, this stage is for you. Because it's nothing but up, up, and away from here on out. But you gotta be quick, you gotta be good, not only with your platforming, but with your reaction times, because very few places in this level are safe to stand. Many, many platforms in this level will crumble away as soon as you step on them, so you need to be ready to react quickly and get a move on. Very few places are safe to stand. Ironically, these swinging platforms might be the safest part of the whole level, because they don't crumble as soon as you step on them. Ooh, that was close. I actually did not mean to go through that sequence that quickly. Luckily, I was able to reach the platform. Anyway, go over here, and you'll find your second bonus area, and the last one. This is the final bonus area of World 6, so let's go ahead and get it done! And that's already 4 out of the 5 puzzle pieces for this level, so we're collecting the puzzle pieces pretty efficiently, but that's not gonna help us. I didn't even get to see what happened on the Hawpog capture window, which is like a 7-second delay between real time and the capture. I guess I just simply... I was reluctant to try and hold left to try and land on the platform because I didn't want to touch the spikes, but I don't know, that sequence was weird. That was a weird death. Well, at least I don't have to go through the bonus again. Like I've said before, luckily in this game, the puzzle pieces are permanently collected. The only way we lose the puzzle pieces is if I were to quit the stage before beating it. But the journey continues. Let's see, we got 1 Kong letter to go, 1 puzzle piece to go, so as far as collectibles are concerned, we're doing pretty well for ourselves, and what was that? Only 1 failure so far? So the practice is starting to pay off a little bit, and that's sort of... Ah, crap. I wanted to go for the extra life, and I lost a life in the process. Like I said, I did put in some practice, because that's sort of what... To put it mildly, that's sort of what's been killing me. Literally and figuratively in this world. What's been killing me is that I haven't really practiced some of the stages as much as I should have. Like that minecart level where I had a rough time and I was cutting a lot of failures out. Man, I really should have practiced that one more. And of course, we got barrel cannons here that will really test your timing. You really need to have your timing down, especially for these right here. But we're actually at the end of the level. All we need to do is pound this cactus to get the final puzzle piece. And now one final section... made it! Whoo! That was something. Got every collectible on the first visit. Alright, and that is Cliff Top Climb. No backtracking! No backtracking for this video. I am pleased with that. We also unlock the bonus level for World 6, but once again, we are skipping over the bonus levels for the time being. And this time, the level does not tease us. For real, we now have the path to the boss of World 6, and it's time to take care of business. It's time for 6-B, Thugly's High Rise. Things are about to get thugly, I can tell you that. Very thugly indeed. Let's do this thing! Here we go, the boss of World 6, Thugly. Thugly is basically an enhanced version of Mugly from earlier, but this is anything but a stale rehash. Thugly is a far more difficult opponent than Mugly was, mostly because he takes more hits, he has a little more variety in his attacks, and there are actually some more hazards you'll have to deal with in the boss arena. But he has three basic attacks in the first phase. First, he charges at you and doesn't hit the wall while exposing his back. But then he'll do something like this, where he will jump into the air and crash down with a belly flop, releasing a shockwave. And then he'll also run into the wall and hit it, causing himself to stagger back and expose his vulnerable belly. Now, you have plenty of opportunities to hit him. You can either jump on his back, or you can wait for him to do the charge where he staggers and falls on his back. Basically, a good rule of thumb for this fight is don't get greedy. You will have there will be times where his back will be exposed, but only for a very short moment, and it might not be a good idea to go for the hit. Anyway, that's the end of the first phase. Every phase ends after three hits. Now for the start of the second phase, duck and stay down. Because now Thugly will introduce fire breath to the equation. Duck. That is the only way to avoid that stream of fire, is to duck and stay down, because otherwise, well, you're gonna get burned, needless to say. When you play with fire, you should expect that to happen. He'll still do the charging into the wall attack, but as you can see, the rocks will now fall from a different area from the ceiling, but... And sometimes he won't stagger as much. Sometimes he won't stagger at all. Other times he'll stagger almost the length of the arena and you gotta stay out of his way. He'll still do the shockwave. And now I believe the cycle is going to reset. Play this boss enough times and you will be able to get the pattern down pretty quickly. He does have a pretty discernible pattern. And once you learn his tells, like what he's gonna do before launching an attack, you can pretty much figure out what to do and react accordingly. Alright, second phase done. Now for the final phase, and if you go into the final phase with full health for both of your Kongs, you should be able to win. But he is gonna throw you off. Now he's bright red, Now he's gonna mix things up a little bit. He's still gonna do fire attacks, but now he's gonna launch a fireball that will split into smaller fireballs. But he'll still do the charging attacks and everything else too, so... He doesn't completely change the game plan, but he will introduce new moves to throw you off, obviously. Still got the fire stream. Once again, duck under that. There's no other way to avoid that attack, believe me. You cannot jump over that attack, because by the time you can't even avoid that by jumping over it with Diddy, because Diddy's jump jets will run out, and you'll fall right into the fire. So yeah, just duck and save yourself the trouble. Also, another tell, when he pounds the ground 3 times with his hind legs, that means he's going to do the jump and belly flop maneuver. So again, learn his tells and you'll know which attack he's going to do so you can react accordingly. Again, when he retracts his armor like that, don't be greedy, because like what happened there, I got hit trying to go for it. It's easy to get greedy and try to finish him off quickly. And I just lost Diddy, so this is a bad situation to be in. Luckily, he's going to do the charge into the wall and get over there. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Let's go! Once again, I missed the timing for the combo. I was waiting for the Wiimote indicator to pop up and it didn't, so my timing was off. But, nonetheless, World 6 is done. We are finally gonna move on from this place. Thugly has fallen, and now we move on to World 7, The Factory. Obscured in smog, who knows what waits for us in this world, but I can tell you it's not going to be easy. World 7 is a strong contender for perhaps the most challenging world in the game. And what wonders lay ahead? Well, you're going to have to wait until the next video because we are stopping here. That is a wrap on this episode of the Donkey Kong Country Returns playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.